أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إنا أرسلناك شاهدا ومبشرا ونذيرا لتؤمنوا بالله ورسوله وتعزروه وتوقروه وتسبحوه بكرة وأصيلا. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. فالحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ثم ما بعد, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. القرآن weekly. We are now on the 26th juz. This is exciting. We're getting close to the end. Alhamdulillah. And the ayah I've chosen for today belongs to Surah Al-Fath. Surah Al-Fath is the 48th surah of the Quran. These are the 8th, and this is the 8th and the 9th ayah actually of the surah. And this is something all of you should know is Surah Muhammad, Surah 47, Surah Al-Fath, Surah 48, and then Surah Al-Hujurat, Surah 49. All three of these together are a pretty comprehensive course in the Quran on what does it mean to believe in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and what does it mean to respect him and to love him. It's a course on our relationship with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam in one place, and that is 47, 48, and 49. So this ayah is from 48, and it actually has to do with our messengers, our relationship with the messenger. To properly understand these two ayat, you have to understand the concept of iltifat. Iltifat is actually transition. So imagine that I have, you know, as I actually do in my class at the Dream Program, I have brothers on one side and sisters on the other side, right? So I could say, you do this and you do that. Like I'm pointing at two entities at the same time. Or imagine that I'm in a class and there's like everybody's in the class and I have a TA. Right, so I'm saying, okay, you guys get started and you keep an eye on them. Right, so I'm addressing two entities at the same time, and one's a single you, my TA, my teacher's assistant, is a single you, and everybody else is a plural you. So you have to understand that in these two ayat, the first ayah, Allah addressed the Prophet with a you. And in the second ayah, addressed all of us with a you. It's as though Allah is looking from above and He's telling the Prophet, you do this and you do this. Okay, but it's still one conversation. Allah is the speaker speaking to both the Prophet ﷺ and then us in one flow. So he says, إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا. No doubt about it, we have sent you as a witness. He's telling the Prophet ﷺ, we have sent you as a witness. That's the scary part, because if he's a witness, he will testify, and he will testify to everyone who was there. The Sahaba are terrified by that. So Allah fills them with hope again. وَمُبَشِّرًا, and we have sent you as a giver of good news. Now they're encouraged. وَنَذِيرًا, and we've sent you as a warner. So the Rasulullah ﷺ is given three titles. We've sent you as a witness, we've sent you as a giver of good news, and we've sent you as a warner. Now he turns to the Muslims. Now to this day it includes us. لِتُؤْمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. I've sent you, Muhammad ﷺ, as a witness, as a warner, as a giver of good news, as a warner, so all of you, could believe in Allah and His Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's like Allah is telling us to respect Him. First He talked to him, then He said, you see what I just did to him? You see I just sent him as a messenger to you? So you could believe in Allah and His Messenger. وَتُعَزِّرُوهُ. Oh, what a beautiful word. What a beautiful word. So you honor Him and you help Him out of an overwhelming sense of respect for Him. You ever see, we don't really see this much anymore, but if a student runs over to get like the teacher's bag, let me carry that for you, sir. And he picks it up. Or you know, an old man comes into the masjid and he's about to take his shoes off. Let us put those up for you on the rack. Let us get that for you. Or your dad's about to, you know, pack the car with luggage. Dad, you don't carry that, I'll carry it for you. Like this overwhelming sense of respect, and you help someone not because they need help, but because you couldn't tolerate them having to do something when you're there. Out of respect for them, that's ta'zir. Allah says, you better have that emotion towards my messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This overwhelming sense of respect driving you to help him. But how can we help him? He's gone. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's not in our company anymore. So how are we supposed to help him? Allah will teach us the dua that the Prophet ﷺ used to make, that he taught us to make. Allahumma ansur man nasara deen Muhammadin sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. O Allah, help whoever helps the deen of Muhammad. In the Surah Al-Saff, Allah has taught us, man ansari ila Allah, who will help me towards Allah? Isa said. Nahnu ansarullah, the Hawariyun said. You know? We, by helping Allah's, the Messenger's deen, are actually honoring Him. Now imagine every time you do something for Allah's deen, you don't just remember your intention is to please Allah Azza wa Jal, you also, part of a legitimate intention is out of an overwhelming sense of respect and grandeur of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you rush to do what you're supposed to do for this deen. لِتُعَزِّرُهُ. Then he adds وَتُوَقِّرُهُ. You know وِقِّر means a burden, a burden. تُوَقِّرُهُ means you understand that he is a grand personality. That when he is spoken of sallallahu alayhi wasallam, there is a grandeur, there's a seriousness, there's a weight. It's a weighty matter. It's not someone light that's being talked about. It's not someone casual that's being addressed. That your face, your emotions, your attitudes, all of them just immediately change when you hear his name sallallahu alayhi wasallam. وَتُوَقِّرُهُ. You better do that. Now still Allah is talking to Muslims. So we sent you, O Muhammad, with this, this and this, to be a witness, to be a warrant, to give good news, to be a warner, so that you Muslims better honor him. You better honor him and help him out of that motive to honor him. And you better make a big deal out of his name, out of his mention. You better make a big deal out of just respecting him and being serious when his name is mentioned. That it should not be a light matter to you. وَتُسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. And you should declare Allah's perfection night and day. Subhanallah. Allah said, you better believe in Allah and His Messenger. And then that's how the ayah began. I sent him so you can believe in Allah and believe in His Messenger. Then the ayah switched. Because the first thing mentioned in the ayah was Allah, the second was Messenger. Then the ayah switched and started talking about the Messenger. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. تُعَزِّرُهُ وَتُوَقِّرُهُ. Then the ayah came back to Allah again. It ends with Allah again. وَتُسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. So you declare Allah's perfection night and day. Night and day. Now what does that mean at the end? This waw could be waw bayaniya. It is by showing respect and regard and, you know, seriousness to the relationship you have with Rasulullah ﷺ, and to keep him in the honor and the status that he deserves, that is actually one form of understanding what does it mean to do tasbih of Allah, to declare Allah's perfection. Part of the tasbih of Allah, you can only get there if you show respect to his Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. If you don't have respect for his Messenger, you will not be able to have respect for Allah. You're not going to be able to declare Allah's perfection. You're not going to know what that means. Subhanallah, and I know this to be true for a fact. The more interactions I've had with people of other faiths, their relationship with Allah is so weird. It's so weird. They say things about Allah you couldn't imagine as a Muslim. You're like just disturbed when you hear it. How can you talk about Allah like that? How can you talk about God like that? Then you realize the relationship they have with their prophets. Oh, that's where it comes from. You're not able to have tasbih of Allah because you don't have ta'zir and tawqir for your messengers. You don't have that honor and that gravitas for your messengers, and that is not letting you have the proper relationship with Allah. That is what we're learning in this ayah. May Allah make us those who honor our Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, and have the utmost respect and this burning desire to help his cause and to make that cause our own out of that sense of loyalty to him. Barakallahu li wa lakum wa sallallahu ala rasulihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.